See, you outside of faith is sin, right? So that's giving a place to the devil when you doubt. Remember, Jesus rebuked the disciples because they doubted. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm trying to help you out, go to this next realm in God. I came down here with no money, literally, period. But you know what I came? Because I told the man of God, I'm coming. I said, you know, he called, he said, you coming? I said, sure, I'm coming. I said, you know what? Because this is a man that when I was in a house and I lost everything, kids, family, everything, he would always see about me.
Amen.
He would preach for me. When other people kicked me to the curb, he'd preach for the convocation. You know, he preached. This is a preacher, you know, a preacher machine. You know, he can preach. Amen.
Amen.
And he'd come for 5-day revivals. And when he'll come, he'll just come and say, you know what, you all right? You need anything? That's a real friend. Amen. So we want to honor the man of God, the woman of God. Also, God says now, because I told them, and it works, double your tithes. What do you mean? If you're getting $500, don't get $50. You want to know why? Because you're breaking the lid, you're breaking the restriction. She went from 9 to 20. You see what I'm saying? You need to double your tithes to your pastor. Amen. I'm telling you, it works. It breaks limitation. It frees you from the system. Amen. How many people promise that they will start giving better? I want to see hands. Not no just giving tithes. Some people give tithes and don't give no offering. God ain't worried about you. He wants you to give tithe and offering. You give $1 for the tithe. I mean the offering. Well, the Lord know I got to pay my bills. No. Give him some. Give him a sacrifice. Amen.
Amen.
I'm trying to help you out. Because God is going to blow you. Y'all see them people getting thousands of dollars. Thousands of dollars. Big houses. A lady that supposed to come from Marshall that just got a house paid for. People spared. Her baby daddy was spared from bullets that came against them. An angel came and ricocheted. He was stabbed and shot. And God spared his life. These are the type of things that's going to happen in y'all life. When y'all honor y'all leader. You will never have to want for that. The Bible says in Acts 4 that they never lacked. I didn't say, God, let that be my portion. That I never lack. In Jesus' name. In
Jesus' name.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, because they have honored your word. God, we pray, God, that you will blow their minds. God, we pray, God, that you will visit them even at night. That you will send angels.
Yes.
To visit them, to speak to them, to lead them, to guide them. Even as you did, glory to God, in the days of Acts. And you did all through the scripture. God, we pray, God, that you even build their faith. Because we know that there's getting ready to be trying times. You showed me people being shot. And all type of things as they ride in their cars. People's just going to be shot. People's going to be killed. I've seen so many people killed in car wrecks and different things. Look like they flipped out of cars and different things. God, we pray, God, that you put a hedge of protection over every person that's under the sound of my voice. God, that you create a blood wall over their doorposts. In Jesus' name. God, we pray, God, that everything that has been hindering them will be no more. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Now I'm going to give it over back to Pastor Bailey.
Amen. 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 We're going to put our hands together. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. We thank God for him. Amen. Coming down tonight. Amen. Allow the Lord to give him a word.
Yes.
That will strengthen the body and that will help us. Amen. It is good to see everybody. Amen. And I'm glad for you that I've stayed. I know, amen, that many got to get up in the morning and had to leave, but you stayed today and I'm glad that you did. Amen. And I'm glad to see all of my friends west of Malakoff. Amen. Good to see all of you. Amen. Coming down and to be in this service. Amen. I don't know if some of this is your first time here. We want you to know that we're happy that you came tonight, and with my prayers that God will continue to bless. bless you. Amen. Continue to strengthen you. We will be back tomorrow night, amen, at 7:30. And we're looking to have a higher time in the Lord. Those of you that can come, we want you to come and be a part of this last night, tomorrow night. Amen. Amen. I believe that God is going to do some great and mighty things us. Yes. Amen. Thank God for Open Door.
Amen.
With us. Thank God. Amen. For them. Amen. My good brother back there, thank God for you. Amen. I knew your name throughout the whole. I know you. You know I know you. Amen. What is it again? Thurston. Brother Thurston. Amen. We're glad to have you. And Brother Cameron, amen, who is always, amen, come down from time to time and fellowship with us on Thursday night. And I'm glad to have him with us. Amen. To my good friend that I just met. I don't know this sister. Amen. But I do know that the hand of the Lord is upon her. And there is a great demand for you even in this hour. And even as this demand comes upon your life, if you operate in what God is calling you to, it's going to almost be that they're going to be thinking like, well, she pushing against leadership. And it has nothing to do with that. But it has to do with the demand that's upon your life. Yeah. And even as you begin to operate and as you begin to go forth, God is going to bring another level of respect to you. Because even for about the last 3.5 years, it's almost as if there's been a fight and people can't really see the hand of God and even what God is taking you to. But God said, this is the hour that he should cause you to rise up. And even as you rise up, those that have looked down upon you and those that have overlooked you are going to come back and respect the anointing that is upon your life, because you've been faithful and you have been faithful to God. And because of that, this is your hour of this. Come on, give God a praise. Amen for that word of God. We thank God for all of you. Listen, we'll be back tomorrow night, and we're looking, come on, for Sister Jasmine, and, amen, and her good friend that's been traveling. It seems like everywhere Brother Marquis goes, she's right there with him. You stay committed to them, and you stay faithful to them, and God's going to do some great and mighty things. He's already done some great and mighty things in your life, and we thank God. Listen, come back tomorrow night, amen, and we want you to come back tomorrow night with a looking for God to move, amen, and we want you to pray and ask God to give you a great sacrificial offering to be able to bless the man of God. I know it's not easy for Prophet Marquis in ministry going to and fro, and it's tough sometimes when you're operating full-time ministry. Because people don't understand what you have to go through, and they think you just won't. But that's not the way ministry works. It's you got to have it. And so we want to be able to help him, amen, on tomorrow night. And so we thank God. Anything else? Amen. We'll be back here tomorrow, 7:30. We'll be back here tomorrow night at 7:30. Amen. We're standing all over the building. Good to see you. I appreciate you staying, my friend. Hallelujah. Thank God for you. When I say unto one, thank God for the prophet. Amen. Roy Lane. Amen. Thank God for him being with us. Amen. When I say unto one, I say unto all, honor your leader, and God will honor you. Shake somebody here and tell them you love him in Jesus' name.
Yeah, I say.